Hello viewers, welcome to Elim TV, a station where you watch and learn. Your teacher today is Mr. Wanyoike, an agriculture teacher. In today's lesson, we are in Form 3, Lesson 2, and the topic is Livestock Production 3. And the subtopic is Female Reproductive System. On to the lesson objectives. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to, number one, explain the function of various parts of female reproductive system in cattle, and number two, define the term pregnancy and or gestation period. The second one is define the term pregnancy, and also pregnancy is the same as gestation period. Then we have highlight pregnancy periods of different livestock which are layered in the farm. Then we have terms used. We have ovulation, and the term ovulation it means that the process of releasing a mature ovum into the oviduct. Then we have pregnancy, the term pregnancy of gestation period. This refer to the duration between the time of conception up to the time of giving birth, when the animal will give birth. And therefore that time in between the time of conception up to the time of parturition or the time of giving birth is what we refer to as pregnancy or gestation period. Then we have parturition. On the other hand, parturition refer to the act of giving birth, or that process of giving birth is what we refer to as parturition. Then we have correct presentation. Correct presentation, on the other hand, it means that whenever the livestock is giving birth, for example, a cow is giving birth, the four legs should come out first, being in between the head being in between the four legs. That is what we refer to as correct presentation, meaning that the head and the four limbs comes out first and the head lies in between the two four legs. Then we have breech presentation. It means that any other form of presentation, any other form of giving birth, you can have it as only the head coming out without having the legs, or the legs coming out first without head being in between them, or the hind limb coming out first. That all these are what we refer to as a breech presentation. Then there is an example of presentation. You can see there is an animal which is giving birth, and there is correct presentation there. You can see the newborn is being delivered. It is being born, whereby the two legs are in between, the head is in between the four limbs. Then we have in the second one here, we have breech presentation. You can see the part which is of the calf, which is coming out first, is it is starting with the tail. The tail coming out as the first person, first part of the calf, and that is what we refer to as breech presentation. What are the functions of the female reproductive system of a cow? The female reproductive system of a cow is made up of several parts, and the first one you have, the ovary. The ovary is meant for production of the ovules, that is ovum or ovum, and the second part we have the oviduct. The oviduct is meant for fertilization. It is the place where fertilization will take place. Then from there we have another part called uterus. You can see on that cow diagram there is uterus, and the uterus is a part of the reproductive system of a female, where implantation will of the zygote will take place. and also development of the zygote into embryo, then embryo also develop into the foetus. That is where the development of the after conception will take place. Then we have another part is the bladder, the urinary bladder. It is where the urine is temporarily stored, awaiting for the process of urination so that the urine can be passed out through the vagina. Then the vagina or birth canal, it is also referred to as birth canal. It is the part of the female reproductive system where the foetus will pass through in the course of parturition. Then we have the vulva, that is the external part of the female reproductive part on your way to the vagina. Then we have the gestation periods for different livestock which are reared in the farm. We have a cow has a gestation period of 270 to 285 days. Then we have a sow, then it has a gestation period of 113 to 117 so that it can farrow. Then we have the ewe, that is a mature sheep. It has a gestation period of 150 days, while the nanny, that is a she-goat, it normally parturate by the end of the 150 days. Then you have rabbit, that is a doe, a female rabbit is called a doe. It normally lasts for 28 to 32 days. Then we have signs of parturation. What are you supposed to look so that you can know that an animal is about to parturate or an animal is about to give birth? The first one, we have this distended udder. The udder normally grow in size. Then we have swollen vulva. Remember, this is the external part of the female reproductive system. Then we have loose pelvic girdle. Then we have general restlessness, then animal becomes restless, then finally we have discharge of colostrum, that is a fluid coming out through the teat. We have come to the end of today's lesson, and I am going to give you questions. The first question that you're supposed to carry, do them is in form of assignment. The first one is, with a clearly labeled diagram, discuss the reproductive system of a cow. Then the second question is, define the term gestation period, as already well discussed. Then we go to the reference. You can refer from secondary agriculture student book 3, and the publisher is the Kenya Literature Bureau. For more information, if you'd like to clarify something from Elim TV, you can reach us through the following addresses. You can use the SMS using the number which is well displayed for you. Also, you can use the YouTube at Elim TV, then Facebook platform at Elim TV, and finally, you can reach us through Twitter at elimtv_ke. Thank you for joining me in this lesson. Till next lesson, goodbye.